Hello, my name is Maggie Hutchings and I'm an Associate Professor in the School of Health and Social Care at Bournemouth University.
My name's Anne Quinney and I'm a Senior Lecturer in Social Work in the school.
We're joint unit module leads for this innovation project, Exploring Evidence to Guide Practice, an interprofessional unit designed for health and social work students. The project was created firstly to promote research-based learning using case studies informed by the school's research scholarship in lifeworld-led philosophy for humanising care, developed by Todras and Galvin. Secondly, to pioneer innovative pedagogic strategies using technology to connect learners to humanising evidence-based practice. Service user and carer stories, together with evidence from journal articles, health policy and campaigns, are used to immerse learners in the life world of the people they will encounter in their practice. Students are guided through group work and blogging to integrate understandings about different kinds of knowledge. Knowledge for the head, from conventional evidence. Knowledge from the heart, from imagining what it is like for the person experiencing care. Our goal is to achieve knowledge for the hand, transformative learning for humanising care, through developing empathic understanding, critical judgment and ethical sensitivity for guiding their professional practice.
Analysis of the detailed end-of-unit evaluation survey pointed to students appreciating the variety of resources, the flexibility of working both independently and as part of a small group, the opportunities to learn from, about and with students from other professional programmes, and an increased confidence in reading and critiquing research. However, they were sometimes challenged by technology. Moving between appreciating the flexibility of the guided learning activities and wanting more guidance or structure. And the group work also presented difficulties for some students. These are not surprising, as we take an approach that focuses on facilitating learning and encouraging curiosity and creativity in thinking, rather than simply delivering a curriculum. The external examiner has commended the unit for being pedagogically sound, for focusing on real-world practice issues, and for the refreshing learning partnership between staff and students.
We have learnt much from managing and negotiating our way through anticipated and unexpected aspects of leading change and would like to share some key messages. Firstly, the need to articulate and promote a shared vision which can demonstrate benefits for key stakeholders, our students, fellow academics, the professional programmes and the school's leadership team. Focusing on key people at all levels coming on board. Secondly, to develop and maintain a robust team approach for dealing with complexity and uncertainties of change management, built on collaborative working practices and welcoming contributions and constructive feedback. Thirdly, to demonstrate commitment of the project leads to listen, support and encourage. Fourthly, valuing the powers of persuasion and influence to negotiate and manage those organisational boundaries, risk factors and diverse expectations. And finally, building collaborative networks and forming alliances with colleagues with expertise in our own and other universities.
We're planning to refresh the case study materials to continue to ensure that the materials are up to date, engaging and relevant, and to ensure sustainability. There are plans to engage a wider group of staff in the unit to enable their research into professional practice themes and their pedagogic interests to be reflected. Other elements of the professional curricula are adopting and building on the approaches in this unit too. The work of the Service User and Carer Partnership in identifying and recording first-person accounts continues to expand. A dissemination strategy is in place, with a suite of peer-reviewed journal articles and a book chapter already published, and continued international conference activity. The unit has been recognised by a university award for research-informed teaching and a national award for innovation in assessment. Further publications are planned to ensure that the experience from this unit reaches the journals associated with the professions involved, as well as those already published that address a technology-enhanced learning audience.
Participating in the HEA's Learning Technology Enhancement Academy has enabled us to focus on developing strategies for leading change and managing the challenges of changing cultures, the scale of technology infrastructure and support required, and emerging expectations for learning technology provision. The HEA's Critical Friends contribution was pivotal in winning hearts and minds through attending planning group meetings, a launch event, and facilitating a workshop on influencing and managing resistance to change. The HEA enabled opportunities for networking with colleagues in other institutions. Links established proved an invaluable resource for informing the project, and our HEA seminar was influential in raising awareness and informing our direction of travel.